guys? I'm Pete here with Thompson for another episode of SNS Plays, and today we're going to be playing Game Dev Tycoon with you guys, the first game ever released by Greenheart Games. It was self-published back in 2012 before coming to Steam in 2013, published by no one other than Valve themselves. As you guys can see right here, jump right into the game.
Yeah.
The game follows a hopeful game designer who's starting his own game development company in what we can only presume to be his parents' garage, before you move up the ranks, working on more advanced games and moving into the realm of like AAA, stuff like that.
It's a hard decision, right?
Player name.
The hardest decision of all time.
Oh,
the player character name.
Oh no.
Just name him Ozzy.
Cameraman Ozzy.
We got Ozzy behind the camera today, so we'll let Ozzy be our guy.
That doesn't make any sense.
Well, it doesn't make any sense that we made him a guy who looks like Urkel either.
Yeah.
He looks like Urkel.
Alright, you know what? He's Urkel.
Yeah, just name him Urkel. Urkel's the head of our company.
Right,
yeah, that's fine.
Whatever. Unlock hints.
Yeah, why not?
Alright, whatever.
We might need
him. Oh, boy.
Oh, jeez.
What have we done?
We have to override one. Ozzy says just get rid of Black Library.
Okay.
Isn't played in 6 months.
All right,
guys. Okay, so tutorial here.
Yeah, we can go to.
Yeah, right, we'll get through this.
Congrats!
All right, we started our own company right here in the garage, guys.
Sweet.
Much like many young game developers did. So yeah, I don't know if you guys saw this in the very beginning, but this game starts out in the 80s, near like the dawn of the console era,
develop new game.
I don't know.
84, 85.
Oh, 84, 85, I see. Okay, somewhere in that range. It's like, early, computer games and stuff like that, Commodore 64 era, stuff like that. So I'm assuming we're going to start working with some early pixel games. Let's do it. Butt Blaster. Butt Blaster! We were agonizing over what we were going to call our first game all day when we decided we were going to do Game Dev Tycoon. So
is it a romance?
Yeah.
All right.
Romance.
It's a romance adventure.
And action.
Yeah.
Romance, and we'll put it on the PC.
But that's it's a lot cheaper here,
It's got better market
check
share.
Check this out, yeah. I know PC's cool.
Yeah, we'll do it on PC.
PC's great.
We're gonna be ahead of the curve. We're gonna do the PC.
Yeah,
the early adopters.
PC Master Race, there we go. 2D graphics?
2D graphics, yes, yeah. Romance. You gotta
it's a romance.
See.
The butt blasting must happen.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Pork butts and taters.
That's how I like envision butt blasting.
Yeah.
Is that it's like a Duke Nukem X character. Guy's in like a leather jacket and he's got thick black sunglasses, but instead of like a minigun, he's got just a pig. Like, and it's like the pork butts they had in Cow and Chicken.
Oh yeah.
That's exactly how I'm thinking about it.
This is perfect. It's turn to her. Okay. Oh boy. Alright. Butt blaster, the romance action.
I think we definitely want to push storyline, right? Like, we want to push storyline. It's a romance.
And that's a story. The gameplay's it's okay.
Yeah.
The engine, it's pretty solid.
A little bit better because of the graphics.
Got some pluses up there.
Yeah, I want to make the gameplay a little bit better. It's a little embarrassing.
Yeah.
That's good. Alright.
Yeah, the time's
it's our first game. We have all time in the world.
Yeah. Well, we're going to come out strong.
Yeah, with butt blaster.
Alright. That strong butt blasting.
I'm sorry. This is horrible. Alright, so while Butt Blaster is in its first development cycle, I'm gonna talk to you guys a little bit more about the game. So you can pick up the game on Steam or at greenheartgames.com. This is the first game ever released by Greenheart Games. They're currently working on their second game, codenamed Game Number 2. Riveting title. We're looking forward to that one. In development stage 2 already. This is really coming along.
I don't think we need this one so much because it's...
Dialogue's is important, dude. It's a romance.
I mean, look at that. I mean, we don't... The pluses aren't there for
So it's not... Alright.
Let's just keep
AI! Going. AI! We want to have in-depth conversations.
Oh, yeah. And level design's going to be great. You gotta blast those butts everywhere.
Yeah. The dialogue, it didn't transition so well when they region.
It's a teen romance.
They adapted it. Yeah, it's like Twilight.
The writing's a little, It's okay. Alright, now we can pick basic sounds. Oh, that's...
Oh, boy.
Alright. Alright. Yeah, we got some bugs in this game, too.
Yeah, it's not coming along so well.
No, we got 5 bugs. We can fix them, right?
I hope.
I mean...
You can fix bugs if you just hang out by the desk. He'll automatically fix them.
Alright, cool. Well, I mean, this looks solid. It's all pretty even, but...
Yeah, I say we do graphics.
Graphics.
Yeah, oh. That's what we're talking about.
Oh, I got those fine quality pixelated butts here. Them 8-bit butts.
Not just the butts. I mean, like, all the things that that you're shooting with the butts. You're blasting them.
Yeah.
And that's where the romance really comes in, though, you know, because, like, you gotta save the princess. She's in another castle.
Something like the romance comes from shooting stuff out your butt.
Not out of
your butt!
Out of the pig's butt.
That's insane!
It's a pig butt, dude, obviously.
Finished.
He's the butt blaster.
Releasing a game without fixed bugs.
I imagine reviews for butt blaster.
Yeah, alright, cool.
Wait, yeah, we're doing this.
Yeah, no, we're fixing the bugs. It's worth the money.
I imagine the reviews for Butt Blaster as just like, 9 out of 10, would blast butts again.
Yeah,
you would.
Well, 10 out of 10 for this game, it's the greatest.
The development of our game is now finished.
There's no bugs.
Only expect high quality games from SNS games.
Yeah.
Slack and Slash games, right?
Yeah.
That's what we're
calling. So when this, you know, yeah, Slack and Slash, sure. when this comes out on Steam one day, you're gonna know when you saw it here. When the
when Butt Blaster has its real life release.
Oh, oh boy!
Release
this game.
Yeah, this game looks like a classic.
Yeah,
instant
man.
Classic.
It's like, you know, headwaying all this 1980s beautiful technology.
All right. Maybe we'll move out of our parents' garage kit. But I like that DeLorean. That's what that looks like to me. Anyway.
Oh my God, we're gonna go back.
God, we got the reviews. They're coming in. I hope they're good.
Not
four.
Not bad.
Not bad.
Good.
Not good either, though.
Sorry.
Oh, dude.
Okay,
not fun.
Who do you know, Informed Gamer? Who are you?
Dude, disappointing
game hero.
Oh, dude.
God.
Wow.
Oh,
boring.
I think our
boring.
Blasted.
Wow, we got blasted in the reviews.
Oh,
all right.
Man.
Okay. All right. I mean, you know, we're gonna have to try again.
Maybe.
I say, you know, we'll come away from Butt Blaster. We'll try another game.
Dude,
we'll do a reboot on the next gen.
We're just too late.
You
said, the
said come away from Butt.
Oh God. Moderate response. That's one way to look at it. I wouldn't call it moderate. Yeah, develop a new game.
Should we research?
I mean,
research is important to unlock.
Yeah, all right, let's do it. Let's do it. We'll greatly improve our games because our games suck apparently.
Apparently,
new engine.
Yeah, do we have 50 RP? Whatever that is.
I don't know.
No, we don't have any.
Oh
God! Wait.
Oh, not ninjas.
Wait. So yeah, wait. We can jump into City, Mystery, Dance, or ninjas. Maybe ninjas. No, you know what?
I say mystery.
Mystery's a,
mystery.
It's got that M++++ or whatever
that is.
I have no idea. So he's gonna be doing that.
So we're gonna make a mystery game.
Look, we sold 1.0. Oh, look at this, dude!
Oh man,
over 1,000 units of Butt Blaster
in the first week.
Dude, that's a great game.
That's not so bad for a
gamer. Didn't know shit
for such a terrible review, though. I mean,
oh boy,
this is good. It's good.
Second week's doing pretty good. Look at that, man. We're getting some stuff.
Oh, small dip in units, though. It's not so good.
It's all right. Strongest week was the first.
All right, so we learned how to make a mystery. Let's make a mystery game. So what's our mystery
game? Why Butt Blaster wasn't the number one great
game
of all time?
No. I said we're gonna put Butt Blaster away until the next gen.
All
we right. gotta this guy come up with a whole new IP. This is gonna be our.
Well,
second.
This is the '80s. We're at the advent of gaming itself. So like the, you know, whodunit. We could just call it whodunit.
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 All right, one word though.
Who done it?
Question mark. Yeah. All right. Pick topic.
This is a mystery.
Mystery. RPG.
Ooh, mystery. RPG.
This one we'll do for the let's do for the G64. We're gonna
a lot of money.
We're gonna is it more money?
It's 20,000.
Oh wow, yes. Let's do the PC. We'll do the PC.
Also,
it's better.
Yeah,
for
better
what
for
we're
the
doing.
PC. All right, mystery RPG. Who done it? Text based. That's all we can do.
Nah,
3D graphics.
2D. Yeah, we're all about the graphics here at Slack and Slash. We're future guys.
Who done it? All right, baby. All right, development stage one. Gameplay. Out of this world.
Absolutely.
You know what?
Just get rid of the yeah. Yeah, our engine's fine.
It's whatever.
Nobody cared about the engine last time.
The PC's only got like one engine anyway. Look at that. Oh, that's look at that. Oh, we got one bug. That's whatever. Dialogue's gotta be way up there.
Get rid of the AI we already developed. AI in our last game.
It's great. We got this.
I think whodunit might be a really successful.
This is gonna be like the golden game.
Yeah.
I mean, Butt Blaster sales have tanked. You know, we kind of made our money on that. That's it.
We did what we did.
It looks like, world design.
Yeah.
Graphics. Yeah. Sound, it's okay.
It don't even sound, it's a mystery game.
2D graphics. Basic
no,
sounds.
Yeah.
Basic
yeah. Okay.
Spend some money. Intense here.
It's getting tense. It's getting tense, guys.
Because the Butt Blaster sales are off the market.
Oh,
it's off the market. That's not that bad.
It wasn't terrible. It was respectable for a first game.
$31,000 in the 1980s.
Yeah,
like
you know, back
million,
in the 80s. That
it's
was
like $1 million right now.
That might have actually been decent. I'm not sure
what
units were like back in then.
Yeah.
Only like one bug, though. That's not bad. the Govador 64 is steadily outselling competitors in the PC sector.
Wow. That's what we learned.
Yeah.
That's what we learned.
It might spell the
company. See? Great. Oh, wow. And this is a PC exclusive. We're done before we're out of the water here.
Well, we finished the game, but no bugs.
We're putting it out.
Yeah.
No one's going to play it, though.
We might have someone
we'll
play.
We'll see.
Maybe Bill Gates will come by and save us.
I mean, this is a learning experience, at least.
Yeah.
We got it. We learned a lot.
This looks like a solid man. Look at this.
We thought Butt Blaster looked solid, too.
Well, you know.
Release
the game.
If you generate a game report after your game's release, you will receive research points.
Research points?
Whoa.
Okay. The first reviews are in for whodunit, though.
Let's see how we did. Oh, come on, don't tease me like that.
RPG games work well on PC.
All right.
This guy knows what he's talking about.
Six?
Corky,
I'll take
good.
It.
Confirmed gamer. He's coming around. All right.
He hated our last release.
Beautiful! Game hero.
This
yeah,
is
you
what
are
I'm talking about.
That's all I want to hear. Could have been better. All right.
That's fine. I won't argue that.
You
could have been better.
Gotta have
we'll get him in the sequel.
Constructive criticism. You know, let's get this game report.
Generate game report. Let's do it.
Yeah.
Okay. Whodunit, yeah, because no one cares about that.
Not anymore.
Look at this. First week Whodunit already has more lifetime sales than
we have 26 fans! We got fans.
We got fans,
we're
guys.
In. We're in. We did it. We win. Can we give up now and like just ride on this money? Sweet money for the rest of our lives? Our post-release analysis is complete. Mystery and RPG is a great combination. Sound seems good, but not very important. That's fine.
Yeah, alright.
We didn't give a crap about
that.
Yeah, it's doing
good. Yeah, we know. Ozzy already told us game. Thanks.
Thank you, Ozzy. You're better.
Not researchers. Let's strike while the iron's hot and Whodunit too.
You know what?
Or should we invest? Should we invest in some...
Man, that G64 is like rocking right now.
Yeah, you know what? We'll make a new game for the G64. Whodunit port.
We should make, alternate history.
Alternate history?
Got some pluses.
All right.
Oh, man, we need a name for this, too. We gotta figure out what kind of game it is, too.
A sim.
Alternate history? Strategy?
Strategy, yeah, alright.
Oh,
we'll
yeah.
Just set, we'll just shut, alright. Alternate history. How about,
G64.
Alright. Wrath of Joan of Arc.
Oh, boy. Does this fit? Yeah, it does.
It does.
Alright, cool. And this
2D.
Is 2D.
Oh, yeah, all about the graphics.
Oh,
we don't do that text-based.
Oh, stuff. Baby.
10K sold!
This is
what's
a big milestone in history.
Whodunit!
Flash.
It's the
Yo,
greatest mystery game ever released.
Alright, gameplay is up there.
Story quest is not so important. The people. We're gonna work on the engine this time around.
Oh, yeah.
It's a new platform. We gotta work out the
jumping
bugs.
Into that hot G64 market.
Wow, no bugs.
Yeah, great.
Man, Urkel is a hell of a programmer.
Ninvento.
Oh,
Japanese
no.
Company Ninvento.
Dinky King!
Dinky King! Oh no, that home gaming console.
Hey, we're gonna make a game for the Ninvento, like, right after this.
Dude,
we're gonna be ahead
we
of the curve.
Jump right on.
That's what we're all about. We're all about being ahead of the curve here at Slack and
yeah,
Slash.
We're gonna use our, like, amazing foresight to just make
yeah.
great games.
We are. We're gonna make
great.
We're gonna make the next Dinky King.
You know, if we could, you know, get away with the trademark.
Ooh, get some bucks.
It's okay. Right. World design...
Graphics not so important this time around. We already worked on them, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, for this alternate history of strategy, apparently.
I guess a strategy game doesn't really need the graphics so much. It's not as
Yo, we almost got 50 research points.
We're doing good.
We don't
strategy.
Wait for the bugs.
Yeah, right away, fix the bugs.
Flawless victory? Yeah, there we
go. Alright, there we go.
Sweet.
Do it up.
Game off the market.
That's respectable.
Whodunit's doing pretty good.
It's off the market now, though.
Yeah, it did great.
That was respectable, though. I like how that did, guys. Thank you for your support of Whodunit.
Those 26 fans that we don't have anymore. But the Wrath of Joan of Arc is coming.
The Wrath of Joan of Arc is going to be the next-gen experience we've all been waiting for.
It's going to revolutionize gaming just completely. Urkel, you're almost level 2.
Oh, my God. Urkel's pretty legit.
He's great, man. He knows what
he's
doing.
A really good coder.
Yeah. The first reviews are out.
Let's see how it
is. Let's do it.
How it do.
They don't think it'd be like it is, but it do. Shows potential.
Alright, I'll take it.
It does show potential.
So first game on a new platform.
Quirky but good again.
That's what he always says, man. Quirky.
Isn't a crap. Strategy games work well.
That's fine. This is not as well received as the last one, but I'll take it.
But, you know, solid 6.5 average.
I mean, we're trying new stuff. We're trying to diversify our brand.
Yeah.
You know, like,
diversify your bombs.
Generate the game report. Yes, dude.
Alright.
See what we can learn. See how Wrath of
Joan. Yo, look at that. That's
it's
some
selling.
Units sold
selling,
right there.
Man.
Ninvento. Ninvento.
They're gonna put out the TES.
Okay, cool.
Alright. That's fine.
It has a controller.
We're gonna make
Can
it.
You believe that?
Yeah, it does.
A game system with a controller.
It's
unbelievable.
It's revolutionary.
I can't believe it.
Alternate history and strategy is good, and story quests seem to be not important. That's cool. We hit all those points.
Yo, we almost got 50 points.
Contract! Cool.
We could use skill set.
Yeah.
Cool.
Jason,
yeah.
I'll take it.
Let's do it.
Contracts
have now been unlocked. We're going to contract a game?
I suppose.
Alright, do it. Yeah, find contract work.
Literally.
Second option?
Yeah. We're 1 point off, though, from that research.
That's cool. We'll get some experience working on somebody else's game today.
Decide carefully what you want to accept.
Yeah, yeah.
Let's go. Install.
No.
Mirka.
We don't want that.
What about this one? Character design? 4 weeks. Ooh, or Diva program. Ooh.
We get a lot of research points for that, though.
Yeah.
I say we do it.
I'll do this. Accept the contract. Yeah, because, you know, we need research. Oh, that's technology points, actually.
Oh, okay.
Which is okay. Or whatever. I don't know what's going on.
Me neither. I'm just like...
Whatever, we're doing good.
We're trying to figure it out.
Joan of Arc's, you know, making some money.
I mean, we're making some money, though. Like, we're sitting on good...
Damn.
Good amount of change. We got over 200K in the bank.
Wow. And they gave us 21,000.
All right.
That's great. So... Yeah, Jason, that's great.
Cool. Every 6 months, sounds good.
Awesome. We're going to
make our new game.
Wait a minute. Can we go on to the... Oh, wait, let's do some research.
We can't do the Ninvento yet.
Yeah, wait, we got to research real quick. A custom game engine, perhaps?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Okay. 50 points!
And then
1 point left.
How are we doing on time? Hey, cool, yeah, we'll see if we can get one Ninvento game out, and then we'll call it for the first.
Ah, it's off the market. Episode. But that really sold good.
Yeah, it did good for us.
Man, we haven't moved out of the basement, or the garage. That's
hey,
okay.
Why waste money on rent?
Yeah. Hey, we got almost 300 fans.
We gotta, like, appreciate what mom and dad are giving us here.
Yeah. And are we paying them rent?
Nah, probably not.
Good.
Maybe right. This is at the Winslow's house. I don't feel like Urkel's parents liked him very much.
Great custom engine. Oh, look at this.
Yeah, that's right.
Game engine.
I love that show.
Slack and slash engine. All right.
Can we change these things?
I think
yeah, you can. Do it.
Yeah, we're going to evolve it.
Yeah,
we're
going to...
It doesn't matter. 90K, we're investing back in the market. Look at that. Our engine's going to blow them. See, this is why we weren't doing so good. We're going to blow them out of the water. We have our own engine.
Yeah.
We're going to have save game features. We're going to use that Ninvento and have a controller. Like, save games and a controller? Come on. Look at this.
All right. We can make our first game. We're going to make The Legend of Zelda. But not.
Well, when it's done, we're going to make it.
All right, so let's think of a name. We got time. It's The Legend of...
Legend
Ragnar.
Ragnar?
Ragnar the Wanderer!
Oh, man. Why not? I can't think of a better one. Who cares? Yeah, the engine is complete!
Let's do it.
The Slack and Slash engine is... Congratulations.
We will use it in our next game.
Thanks. Thanks to Tori.
Develop new game. Legend of Ragnar.
This game engine. The beautiful game engine. Alright. Legend of Ragnar!
Yeah.
2 hours because it's more Viking-y.
Yeah, I like it.
Pick the topic. I didn't think this was
alternate history.
Yeah, why not? Pick the genre. Action?
How about we do
adventure?
Yeah.
Mm.
Or the RPG. Remember that was good?
Oh, yeah.
It made money for us in the past. We'll stick with it.
We're going to go on this...
The TES.
The TES.
Yeah.
Oh,
we're going to pay the license.
Pay 80 grand?
Yeah,
whatever, man.
We're doing it.
You know what? We're just going to invest everything. Look at that. Best graphics? I don't care. Why not?
We're broke now! We spent all our money! This game better be a success!
Seriously, we just dropped like almost 250,000.
That might have been a mistake, but we're gonna find out.
We're gonna make it work.
We're gonna learn here.
This is gonna make us or break us.
Alright, guys.
We're gonna do both of these.
We're
going to the red.
Oh god, we're in the red.
It's okay, man.
Do it.
Yo, we're gonna make the best
game
ever.
We're gonna sit on all that cash!
Yo, we're gonna.
Oh
we're gonna
no.
Make it. It's okay. We got this.
Oh boy. I hope we do.
Yeah.
Yeah, AI, we don't need it.
I believe in us. I believe in our company. I believe in what we've done. I believe in our game engine. Our fans believe in us. Our 288 fans.
Let's hope they have Ninventos.
Yeah, wait. I didn't think of that. Ooh.
Just gonna...
Ooh. 14.9K in rent?
It's not so good, man. I think I regret...
That monthly cost was coming in, too. We got some bugs you gotta get rid of, too. But, you know, it's...
This game better make some
money
for us, man.
Alright, let's get this out right now. We gotta do this. The Legend of Ragnar. This will be like our Final Fantasy if this don't work, you know? Look at all these level ups, man, across the board.
Whoa.
We're doing good.
We're doing good work here.
Dings.
We're doing good work here.
It's like The Price is Right, ding and everything. Good times. Except for our 2D graphics. So we just started from that.
Urkel just leveled up too. What's up?
The research, game tutorials, and mono sound.
Wow.
Mono sound!
Mono sound!
Dude, I'm living in the future. I can't believe this. Unbelievable.
Alright, let's see. Come on.
Alright,
roll
first
in.
Reviews.
Roll them in.
Alright, nerd. Alright. Believe. Beautiful!
Seven!
Beautiful. Thank you, Star Games. Thank you. Their focus on graphics served the game very well.
Informed gamer, you finally coming through for us, man.
Very good.
Very good.
Very good.
What do we got? What do we got? What do we got?
Alright. Very enjoyable.
This is our best game yet.
This definitely is.
This paid off. This
yeah,
paid off.
Every game's been better than the last. And you know what? Generated game report? About the Legend of Ragnarok.
Do it.
Our average score was 7.75. That's admirable in any market, man.
Wow, first week, look at those sales.
Oh, dude.
Oh,
we're
back in the black. We're back
rich.
In the black.
Oh, my God.
Oh, we're flush with cash.
Oh, my God.
So can you play? Love me!
Oh, wow.
Yeah, those dips.
Ooh, that third week, though.
Third week dip. Oh,
that
man.
Dip was real. But we made our money back. That's all that matters. And we got a bunch of new fans. That was
yeah.
good. No, hold on. This is going to be what we call it for the first episode.
All right,
guys.
Legend of Ragnar.
It's going to... Oh, well, let's see how it does.
Good. I think it's kind of...
It's dipping out. But
yeah.
It might still be our most successful game yet.
We made all our money back in the development cost, though. All
right, okay.
That's
well,
great.
Yeah, that seems like a good place to wrap it up for the first episode. So
yeah.
If you guys want to see some more of Game Dev Tycoon, mm-hmm. which please do. We'd love to move out of our parents' garage. If you want to see more of Game Dev Tycoon, or if you have an idea for what you'd like to see us play next time on the next episode, you can let us know in the comments below, or hit us up on Twitter. If you like the video, make sure you like it, subscribe to the channel, and share it with your friends.
And make sure to follow @slacking/ on Twitter, like us at Facebook, and check us out on slacking/.com.
And until next time, thanks for watching.
Thank you.